has for quite a while played an important role in our development, in our daily work, in many areas of the business.
Artificial intelligence really is present in all our areas within the company.
Artificial intelligence has become a hot topic in recent years. AI-based voice assistants like Siri and Alexa feature prominently in a lot of people's lives. AI also plays an important role in the automotive sector. Today we'll take a deeper look at AI and the possibilities it holds for the future of mobility. AI is the simulation of human intelligence processes by machines. Oftentimes, though, people first think of an AI robot like the Terminator, or the machines from The Matrix that enslaved all of humanity as energy providers.
Oh, hell no!
There are many more examples from Hollywood that draw a frightening picture of artificial intelligence. Of course, all of this is exaggerated for dramatic effect, but there's still a little bit of underlying truth in it. We went to the recently opened Neo Innovation Center in Berlin to talk to an expert who works with AI on a daily basis.
When people think about AI, they think about this big brain that is evolving on itself and then deciding what to do, but it's not like that.
So from an high level perspective, it looks like one single AI brain, but in practice, different technology are involved and we are slicing the AI into a pipeline.
AI consists of several subcategories. One is machine learning, which teaches a computer to use past experiences to make inferences and decisions.
So this is basically what you see here. In the background, so for conversational artificial intelligence, we first start with the audio signal processing to ensure with AI that we have the right quality. Then we continue with the transcription from the audio signal into text. We're also leveraging AI. Then we try to understand the content. And it's also leveraging AI. Then we try to provide a fulfillment and the right answer. And at this stage, we also need AI to synthesize the answer in a nice emotional way. So end to end, everything looks like one brain. In practice, it's a salami.
One example of conversational AI can be found in Neo cars. It's called Nomi.
Nomi is here.
Can you open the left window for me?
Neo was the first car maker to implement in-vehicle AI. Nomi can understand what you want her to do without needing to use a preset command. Even though AI makes it possible for machines to learn, this type of program can only evolve within its boundaries.
So it might be a weakness at the audio component level. We need to add more different kind of nose, for example, and retrain. Maybe we need to add different phonetic alternatives and retrain the transcription. And so on and so on. So at the end, the end-to-end experience will be improved and the AI seems to be smarter, but in practice we just improve one component of the big story.
AI is not only used for car and driver interaction, but also much earlier during the process of developing and building cars.
Our engineers today already use artificial intelligence to specify new products. And also when we start developing software nowadays, we explore for the first time artificial intelligence in a generative way to create software. But also in the plants, we use artificial intelligence for quality assurance and to automatically improve our manufacturing processes.
Just like ZF, Audi has also implemented AI into its smart factories. High-resolution cameras monitor parts of the production process and look for product flaws, like cracks in the material.
AI-based crack detection works like this. We take pictures inside the press using just normal still cameras. The software then does its job in the data center, where the AI model runs and evaluates the images. We send these images with the meta information about the quality, whether the part has a crack or not, back to the control system, which then processes it to give the inspector at the outfeed conveyor the chance to see whether a part is good or bad.
As of now, the final decision whether to discard or to keep a part is made by humans. AI eliminates the necessity for the worker to check every single part leaving the belt. And the AI can work 24/7 without getting tired, and so is way less likely to make mistakes and miss a faulty part. That increases overall production quality and reduces costs. The last aspect of mobility AI we want to focus on today is the self-driving capability of cars.
In particular, for driver assistance systems and autonomous vehicles, we use artificial intelligence for data processing. So data from the cameras, from the radar systems, are really analyzed through artificial intelligence to make smart decisions for the driver.
Fully autonomous cars on public roads is still a dream. There are systems like Tesla's Autopilot and Mercedes Drive Pilot that can drive the car on their own to some extent, but they still only function under certain conditions and require the driver's attention. The challenges for autonomous drive systems are countless. Suddenly appearing obstacles like potholes or animals, unpredictable behavior by other drivers, and bad weather conditions, to name a few. But while full autonomy has not yet been achieved, drivers already profit from AI, be it through better voice recognition, higher quality products, or cheaper prices due to lower costs for the manufacturer.
We use artificial intelligence, of course, in all the development when it comes to autonomous driving, to ADAS systems where AI will help us to recognize the environment of our cars, for example. We use AI technologies in things like forecasting in our business processes, and we also use AI technology in more recent times when it comes to voice recognition or even automatizing dialogues in our functions. So there's many areas where AI can help make us stronger as a company and provide intelligent solutions to our customers.
While some car makers like Opel embrace AI and try to use all the possibilities it provides, others have been hesitant and are just starting to make use of it.
This is Toyota's high-tech concept car, the LQ. It will be unveiled next year at the Paris Summer Olympics, and journalists will be able to try out fully automated driving at SAE Level 4. And AI is essential to that. There's an AI agent called UE in the vehicle which detects the driver's stress level and then controls vehicle function so the stress is reduced as fast as possible.
As of now, Toyota isn't using this AI in its series production cars, but that is set to change sooner or later. Opinions in the industry differ on whether fully autonomous cars will someday become a normal part of everyday traffic. But with the speed at which AI and technology are developing, chances are the younger generations will live to see what still seems like a utopia today.